A very good morning, students. Today we will see the geography subject. In that, chapter number 6, importance of oceans. Now, students, in previous chapter we have seen about the lithosphere and hydrosphere of the earth. Now here we are going to see the proportion of the land and water on earth. So the oceans are like Pacific Ocean, then Atlantic Ocean. These oceans are covered in area of square kilometers. This is Indian Ocean, this is Southern Ocean, and this is the Arctic Ocean. In previous chapter, we have studied the lithosphere and hydrosphere of the earth, the proportion of land and water on earth, and also the major oceans. The hydrosphere includes all the water bodies that exist on the earth. This covers all the oceans, seas, rivers and their tributaries like lakes, reservoirs and also ground water. Of the total number, total global water, 97.7% is contained in oceans. So, the hydrosphere includes the water bodies, okay, and they are covered by oceans, seas, rivers and their tributaries like lakes, reservoirs and also the ground water. Now, figure 6.1 in your textbook, living things in the hydrosphere. Now, we always see the living world around us. There is considerable diversity in the living world on earth. The living world in the hydrosphere is many times greater than the living world on land, and it has a much greater diversity. It is in the figure 6.1. Explanation, page number 33. There is abundant life in oceans. From the microscope planktons of huge whales, different types of living things are found in the oceans. Once they die, their remains accumulates in oceans. All rivers flowing from mountains or hilly areas finally meet the oceans. So all the rivers which flow from the mountains and where they meet at the end to the oceans. Sediments from eroded lands, trees and bushes flowing with the water, dead remains, etc. enter the ocean with the river water. In both the above processes, the dead remains decompose, release various minerals and salts in the ocean water. So, whatever the dead of the remains of the animals are there, they decompose and they release the various minerals and salts in the ocean water. Now, volcanic eruptions on land. Similarly, volcanic eruption take place in the oceans as well as volcanic under the ocean. It is figure 6.3. Can you see in this figure? Volcano under the ocean. During volcanic eruptions, different minerals, ashes, salts and gases are added to the water. This increases the level of salts and minerals in ocean water. Due to the continuous evaporation of oceanic water, the proportion of salt increases. All these things make the ocean water salty. The salinity of ocean water is different at different places. Salinity is expressed in term of miles, that is particles per thousand. The average salinity of oceanic water is how much? 35%. The Dead Sea is known as to have the maximum salinity. Its salinity is 332% more than the oceanic water. We obtain salt from the salty waters. Salt as a substance is obtained by constructing salt plains in the coastal area. It is there in your textbook, student, figure 6.4. All these are the salt plains. This white, all these are the salt plains. And from where do we get this? From the salty water. salt is an item in our diet. Many minerals like phosphates, sulfates, iodine, etc. are also obtained from the sea. We depend on oceans to some extent for minerals. Now, figure 6.5 of your textbook, various food items. Now here, some questions are based on that. We will just go through the question answers. Now first is, which item are included in our diet? So what are the items that are included in diet, students? They are like rice, chapati, thalipit, parathas, idlis, vada, fish, chicken, mutton, etc. are included in our diet. Which item among those shown come under the non-vegetarian food? So what are the non-vegetarian food like fish, chicken and mutton among those shown under come under the non-vegetarian food? Then which of these are prepared from aquatic creatures? Who are the aquatic creature? Obviously fish. Fish items are prepared from aquatic creatures. So this was the question answers which I read for you. Three questions are there. Now explanation. Many of us include fish in our diet. We get fish from rivers, lakes and seas. The proportion of fish in sea is much greater than those in the rivers and lakes. Catching marine animals is a large scale activity the world over. It is one of the ancient occupation of human beings. Though food is the major purpose of this activity, marine animals are the major also used for the production of fertilizers, not only for the eating purpose but also for the fertilizers, pharmaceuticals and also in research, where they are used in pharmaceutical and in research. In India, people mainly consume prawns like kolambi, clams, teaser, crabs, searfish, surmai, mackerel, etc. Many other types of marine animals are consumed in different parts of the world. The life of people from countries that have a coastline largely depends on the sea, especially if there are few other occupations like Seychelles, Mauritius, Maldives, etc. are some of these.